is going on with the atoms when a reaction occurs. And the goal, I can read chemical equations and understand how they communicate what is happening during a chemical reaction. So during a chemical reaction, a lot of things are going on. Bonds between atoms break and new bonds form. We've been learning about covalent bonds and ionic bonds. So the bonds between atoms break and new bonds form. Valence electrons rearrange. The atoms then rearrange because they're bonded in a new way. And energy is released or absorbed. New chemicals are formed. You might think of it, of the atoms as kind of rearranging like Legos or bricks that you might put together and take apart. Now, reactions that happen quickly are fun because they surprise us. When a reaction occurs, there are some signs of it. Color changes might happen. Like here you see some unexpected colors, bubbles, and heat and light are often released. These are all signs that a chemical reaction has occurred. Watch the next part and be on the lookout for some of those signs. Did you see some evidence that reactions were happening? But reactions aren't magic. Electrons and atoms are just moving around. Let's imagine what was happening to the atoms in that water experiment Bill Nye just showed us. He started with water, so water was the reactant, H2O. By adding electrical energy, the bonds connecting the H2O molecule broke. New bonds form to make the products H2 gas and O2 gas. In this picture, you see the H2 and the O2 gas are collecting at the top of these tubes. The water down here was split, and the H2 went to one side and the O2 to the other. Do you know which side is which? So look up here and notice that on this side we have less gas collected than on this side. And then look at the formula for H2O. For every O, one O, there are two H's. We can tell that from the subscript. So it's a 2-to-1 ratio of 2H to 1O. Now do you know which side is the H2 and which is the O? It is a tricky question, but if you said that the O2 was on the smaller side, and the H2 on the larger side, you're right, because there's more H than there is O when it breaks up. Let's review that vocabulary. The chemicals we start with are called the reactants. You should say that after me, reactant, reactant. And the chemicals made during the reaction are called the products. That word you probably heard, product, product. So reactants yield products. The word we use for that arrow is yield. So say that with me. Reactants yield products. The word yield could be thought of as like the word make or create. A chef in a restaurant makes a product to sell. For example, this ramen would be the product that people would want to buy. And the ingredients are over here showing what he had to start with. So ingredients yield products in cooking, but in chemistry, we don't say ingredients, instead we say reactants. Reactants yield products. And just like in cooking, there can be more than one reactant, there can be more than one product also. We communicate what's happening in reactions by writing chemical equations. Everybody say that, chemical equations. Just like the word equations in math, a chemical equation often will have a plus sign on one side, maybe on this side, maybe on the other. It doesn't have an equals sign, instead it has the yields arrow. So here is the chemical equation for the water reaction that you saw earlier. We see that water yields hydrogen plus oxygen. Reactants yield products. Remember when we used these ball and stick models before? So the ball and stick model is showing the bonds between the two H's and the O. And you see that here. Remember the H's are the white ones and the O is the red one. So two H's and one O. And then the products are H2, so bonds break and new bonds form to make H2 and O2. But notice when I just had one water, I don't have enough O to make an O2. But an oxygen like this isn't stable. It's only got 6 valence electrons. So instead, it will always bond to another oxygen from another water. So you'll often see coefficients in chemical equations like this. So 2H2O, we need two waters, and then they will both break up to form an H2 and O2, but I actually have enough hydrogen to make two H's, H2s as well. You're going to learn more about this next week, but that is why you see coefficients sometimes in chemical equations. So did you fill in your notes sheet? If not, you could pause here and do that and rewind if you need to. And in the next part of the video, watch how bonds are breaking between the water molecules and new bonds are forming. And remember that with the models, the red one is oxygen atom and the white ones are hydrogen atoms. And when they're bonded together like this, it's H2O, water. There are 5 types of reactions we will learn. To distinguish between them, we need to recognize elements and compounds. This is a review. An element is one kind of atom. There's one capital letter in the formula. We're going to show an element with our hands with just one finger for that one capital letter or that one kind of atom. A compound is two or more kinds of atoms bonded in a ratio. Two or more capital letters. So we're going to show a compound with two fingers or two fingers together. together like this sometimes. So, element, compound. Two elements, one compound. You say it with me. Two elements, one compound. You can pause here and write down the blue definitions on your note sheet. Then in the following list, write E by the elements and write C by the compounds. So here's the list. I'm looking at this H2, and there's a little 2, but it's only one capital letter. So even though that means two H's bonded, one capital letter, one kind of atom means it's an element. So one capital letter element would write an E in this spot. Go ahead and finish the rest of those and pause here to do that. So here are the answers to all of those. If you want to check yours, and I'll move myself out of the way here, I think. In the next segment, we will be looking at each of these types one at a time. All right, the first type of reaction is called a synthesis reaction. The word synthesis means to come together or synthesize. So when we do, say, synthesis, we're going to bring two fingers or two elements together. Let's watch the video to see a synthesis reaction. He said oxygen from the air, O2, and iron in the steel wool. Iron's symbol is Fe. Now notice that that is a element, O2, and Fe, one capital letter, is another element. So we have two elements coming together, and they are going to make a compound. And we always put the cation first. Iron is a +3 and oxygen's a -2, so Fe2O3. And let's watch the reaction. Okay, so we saw the iron in the steel wool and the oxygen reacted and a lot of energy was released, and it's because the atoms were rearranging and electrons were changing places, and we call this a synthesis reaction. Let's watch one more reaction that he is going to do now and see if you think it's a synthesis reaction or is it a different kind. Okay, did you catch that? When he blew up the balloon, he said there was hydrogen, that's an element, and oxygen in the balloon. And when he ignited it, boom, they came together to make the compound water. And that water vapor went into the room, so we didn't see it. So again, two elements make a compound, and that is a synthesis reaction. Synthesis. The next type of reaction is a decomposition reaction. Say that out loud, decomposition. You've heard that word maybe with rotting food or leaves outside. Decomposing means to break up into smaller pieces. Reactants in a decomposition reaction are always a compound. That compound might have two elements bonded in a ratio, or it could be three or more. And those break down into smaller pieces. So you see in the products, either a compound breaks into two elements, or a compound breaks into an element and a compound, maybe. So there is a plus sign on the product side of our equation here. This is the opposite of the synthesis reaction we just saw. Here is an example you're going to see in the video. H2O2, that's not water, that's hydrogen peroxide, which is sometimes used to clean wounds. You might have seen it in a brown bottle. Hydrogen peroxide will decompose into water and oxygen. And you'll see the oxygen in the form of a bunch of foam, because the gas bubbles will puff up, and you'll see that. And then the next reaction is a combustion reaction. Combustion, combustion. Combustion is a fancy word for burning. And the reactants in a combustion reaction are always a fuel like gasoline or even paper or wood. These fuels all have carbon and hydrogen as their main parts. And that reacts with oxygen to release a lot of energy, but also carbon dioxide and water. The next two kinds of reactions are kind of alike in that they are both considered replacement reactions, where ions switch partners. Look at this sodium chloride bond here. We're going to think of the sodium and the chloride, a cation and an anion, as partners because they bond because opposites attract. But what if this bond here broke and a new bond formed with a different partner? The first type of replacement reaction we're going to look at is the single replacement reaction. Single replacement reaction. And in a single replacement reaction, the reactants are an element and a compound. The element, the single one, switches places with one of the ions of the compound.
When the band began to play, the stars were shining bright.
Now the milkman's on his way, it's too late to say goodnight.
Here we have an example that you'll see in the video, Fe plus CuCl2, Fe and Cu switching places, and you'll see that Cu, which is copper, like a penny, will be produced. Here you can't see the copper because it's not in its element form, but here you do. The next type of reaction, the double replacement reaction, often shows a colorful precipitate. A precipitate is a solid that's produced from two liquids. So you'll see in the test tube that a solid is produced. Notice when we see all the different letters, it gets a little more hard to see. But when you see a plus sign on both sides of the arrow, and you see a compound, these are both compounds, and over here too, there's lots of capital letters. That's usually a double replacement reaction. So you're going to see these two reactions in the next video.
We're going to do a double replacement reaction with potassium chromate and silver nitrate. Here's my potassium chromate, and I see that when I add silver nitrate to it, I am forming a nice red precipitate. And the precipitate is silver chromate. And we are going to mix potassium iodide and lead nitrate. So I've got my lead nitrate in here, and I'm going to add some potassium iodide to it, and we're going to see right away that we get a precipitate of lead iodide. What a pretty precipitate.
All right, let's do a quick review. So what type of reaction is this? First thing I need to do is look at whether I have elements or compounds on each side of the equation. So in my reactants, I have something with two or three capital letters and another one with a plus sign between. So that's two compounds. So when you're trying to do this, I recommend using your fingers if you're struggling. So two compounds, and on this side, I have two more compounds. And notice that the H and the Na traded places. So this is a, right? What is it? Two compounds that have switched partners, like two partners, couples dancing. If you said double replacement, you are correct. All right, how about this one? What type of reaction is this? Let's use our fingers again. I see a plus sign here in the reactant side. One capital letter, and on the product side, they're together, and so they're bonded. So two elements became one compound. What type of reaction is it when two elements become one compound? If you said synthesis, you are correct. Remember, synthesis. All right, next one. Here I see a compound plus an element, and on this side, it's a compound and a compound. Now that's a little confusing because this is the one that is different than all the rest. We have a compound and an element, but that element is oxygen, and on the other side, it's two compounds, and I see it's carbon dioxide and water. This is the one where if we take away oxygen, things stop burning, and so this is combustion. This one's not combustion with this oxygen because this is two becoming one and there's no carbon dioxide or water. So you have to remember that one is kind of different and kind of special, harder to remember. So that one is combustion. All right, how about this one? Take a look at it, and if you're struggling, use your fingers. We have a single element, one capital letter, plus a compound, and then they are switching partners, but we still have an element and a compound. So it's element and compound, switching partners, element, compound. So what is that one? You said single replacement, you are right. All right, how about this last one? Use the fingers if you need to. Look at the reactants, there's no plus sign. It's just one compound, two capital letters, so it's a compound. And on the product side, it's two elements. So one compound breaking up, decomposing into two elements. Compound breaking up. If you said decomposition, you got it.